Back inside the Blue Zone, Joel Erickson of IndyStar here to break down so much that has happened this week. And Joel, we were talked after the game in Gillette Stadium that you'd be surprised if it would be another quiet week here based on the last couple weeks. Well, it was not a quiet week, but I don't think you would have predicted that Jeff Saturday would be head coach at this point.
No, and I don't think anybody would if anyone's been paying attention to just the reaction from around the league and from, you know, other teams, from national people. Jeff Saturday, this is unprecedented in terms of what the Colts did, bringing in somebody who had not been coaching, doesn't have coaching experience in the college or the NFL. And we're going to find out, starting with this game against the Raiders, what it looks like with him on the sideline.
What are your impressions of Saturday so far? Because we've had a few chances to talk with him. Obviously, he's inexperienced, but he wins press conferences, at least from my perspective.
Yeah, personable, obviously. Yeah. I think the leadership that people talk about is sort of obvious. He's very energetic, aggressive. Now, Shaq Leonard said earlier this week, energy doesn't necessarily win you football games.
Right.
And that Frank Reich had a lot of energy, too. So it's going to have to be more than that. We'll find out what that is as we start to get into these games and have more of a backlog of information to work with. But at the very least, this is somebody who's going to be, you know, rah-rah, pump the guys up, try to get them some juice going. And what's been a very difficult week for them, I think the locker room really expressed its hurt at the Frank Reich firing this week.
Saturday says that Sam Ellinger is his starting quarterback, but Matt Ryan is now his backup. He is back. He will be behind Ellinger for this game against the Raiders. Do you think there's a chance that we see Matt Ryan?
It sounds like it from what Jeff Saturday said. You know, this isn't a closed competition. This could go either way. And it makes you wonder, they made the move to Ellinger to get more points. Well, they've only scored an average of 9.5 points so far. If they go 3 and out 4 times in a row, or they have some turnovers, do they move back to Ryan? This Raiders team is a team that is terrible against the pass. If Ryan was starting and back where we were at the beginning of the season, you'd feel like that was a good matchup for them.
What about your keys to the game? Joel Erickson, IndyStar, follow him online on Twitter at Joel A. Erickson. What about your keys to the game this week as the Colts take on the Raiders?
Well, I think the number one is just block Max Crosby. This is a Colts offensive line that has struggled to block anybody. This is a great opponent for that because they only have 9 sacks. They have the fewest sacks in the NFL. But Max Crosby, the defensive end for the Raiders, he's got 6 and 12 quarterback hits. And we saw last week that it's really easy to kind of get those guys in positions against right guard, left tackle, the positions that have been the weakest for the Colts. They've got to find a way to block him. Number 2, they have to be aggressive in the passing game. The Raiders defense, as bad as it's been against the pass, is pretty good against the run. So even with Jonathan Taylor back, you assume they're going to try to do that. But where this team has been weakest is in the pass. They got to get those playmakers, Michael Pittman Jr., Alec Pierce, Paris Campbell. They got to get them involved again. We didn't see much of them at all last week. And then the last one is build a wall. When the Raiders offense has been good this year, it's been because Josh Jacobs has run the ball well. Now, the good news is Grover Stewart and DeForest Buckner are almost a wall unto themselves. And now they've got Quiddy Pay back. He had a great game last week. So you feel like the Colts will win that matchup, but that's been the key with this Raiders offense, especially since they put 2 of their best weapons on IR this week.
Joel, if there is one team for the Colts to play this week when so much change is happening, it could be the Raiders, because I mean, they have several players out there. They've lost 3 in a row. They're 2-6. They're kind of reeling themselves.
Yeah, absolutely. In fact, if there's any team in the league that's been more disappointing than the Colts, given where their preseason expectations were, it's this one. It's the Raiders. And they haven't rushed the passer well, which has been the Colts' problem all season long. Offensively, they're not really going through Devontae Adams. The running game, that plays well. It plays into the Colts' hands. You could not give Jeff Saturday a better opponent, I think, other than maybe like the Houston Texans or somebody for his first game.
We'll see what happens. Joel Erickson, check out all his work online, www.indystar.com. We'll be right back inside the Blue Zone.